What up? This is Rama Screen, and I'm here talking with the director of the new movie Under Wraps, which premieres Friday, October 1st on Disney Channel and on Friday, October 8th on Disney Plus, Alex Zam. How are you, Alex?
Oh, pleasure to meet you, Rama. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you as well. Congratulations. So in the process of updating this story to bring it from the 90s to today for today's generation, what were some of the things that you took into consideration? What were the things that you left out versus what the things that you kept?
Well, you know, we had something simple that just that people didn't have cell phones back when they made that movie. So we're constantly looking at language, what music they might be listening to, hairstyles, vehicles, you know, things like that that we can update. But I think it was just for me, the big thing was being true to the original. It's a beloved movie. It was one of my favorite Disney Channel movies. And so we wanted to be absolutely true to the spirit of it, which is kids on the most incredible adventure with a supernatural being who comes into their lives and they solve a mystery and solve a crime. So we wanted to stay true to that, but we also wanted, I was hoping to make a very fast-paced movie. So it was very much on my mind throughout to have the actors speak at a very fast rate, a clip like almost, we watched a lot of screwball comedies to show them that. And also to have the villain be not disappear. In the first one, they did a great thing. They had him disappear. He fakes his own death. In this one, I said, I think I can get a lot of fast pacing by having him constantly searching and on the trail of the kids looking for his missing mummy. So that was a big thing, as well as embracing dance. Phil Wright, just an incredible dancer and choreographer. We had an actor who could do fantastic moves. So we said, let's embrace dance in this as well.
What about the design for the mummy, which is now played by Phil? The design doesn't look far different from the original, isn't it? Are there alterations to that as well?
You know, mummies, I've studied a lot of monsters and mummies, and there's such a history of how they're done, whether how they're wrapped differently. In this one, I thought it was, I gave him more wrappings across his face. There was a little more openness on the first one. We gave him contacts to give him a supernatural look. I was very concerned. I didn't want it to look like a person underneath the mummy costume. So we gave him wonderful supernatural contacts. The other one was we're using silicone makeup, which moves very differently than latex, which was the original. It moves with the actor's face. So we played a lot with his dentures. We had special dentures made for him. So he had decayed teeth. And we offset his jaw. That was a really a special thing that we did work with. We have an amazing special effects makeup team in Vancouver. And what we wanted to do was to offset his jaw. And so it gave him a certain vulnerable cuteness. It wasn't actually repulsive. It actually made him look, you know, just kind of cute when he's trying to talk. So there was a lot of stuff we did there. We also used very lightweight costume so that it would move fluidly with Phil because he had to be able to dance in it. He had to be able to stunts. There was quite a few things that it had to do and we wanted him to be fluid with it.
The chemistry between the lead actors in any movie has to work. And this is fantastic between Malachi, Sophia and Christian. Was it a long audition process to come down to these three? And what's it like working with these young talents?
You know, I've worked a lot with young actors and it's so important to create an environment where you can bring out that chemistry. So first part was a casting and it was a very extensive casting process of looking at hundreds of people where we were trying to find people who imbued those real qualities that Malachi had the quality of somebody who was adventurous in that way and yet vulnerable. And Christian was comedic in just the exact right way, playing his nervousness about dealing with the unknown, his fearfulness in just the right way. It was perfect. And Sophia, smart, can do, intrepid. We wanted some, and so those actors had all those qualities. And once we found them, we played a lot. We've met people. We tried men for the women's roles, women for the men's roles. We tried many configurations, but the goal was to not look at gender, not look at ethnicity, and just find the best cast and to be as inclusive as possible. When I deal with young actors, any actors, we want to create a team. So we called ourselves Team Mummy. Every day we put our hands in at the beginning of the day and end of the day, and we treated them like a band. And they were really helping support each other's performances, a lot of dinners out together, playing and hanging around together, really to build the team and the look, the journey is as important as the destination. So I like to have a fun ride while we're getting there. And these, you know, kids are amazing people and their families are amazing. So we wanted to have fun every day. We knew we were going to work hard. We might as well have fun too.
Is this a potential franchise? Will there be Under Wraps sequel?
I would love to know the movie you'd like to see. Would you like to see a sequel? Because I think if a movie's done well, it suggests other stories with those characters. So look, I could see many stories with these wonderful kids and them. And, you know, if you can bring a mummy back once, why not do it again?
Yes. And for my fans at home, everybody go check out Under Wraps, premiering October 1 on Disney Channel and October 8th on Disney Plus. Alex, thank you for talking to me and congratulations.
Thank you, Rama. Really a pleasure to meet you.